kill steal. That one's actually luck. I actually didn't hear that one. Neither did I make this next one. I just decided to camp here for one, for no particular reason. But then I started hearing the tank. And so I got my gun ready. Easy, easy kill. This song capping an opponent, so. Yeah, it's quite a butt shot, but I'm actually killing. Run by an ammo. Because why not? Sounds cap here. I just see him. Stopped the wrong spot though. Got 5 shells left. Someone starts capping again. And I just wait, and there he is. There's 2 players left at this point. I kind of just waited out here. He knows I'm here because he hears my engine, so I decided to pull back, but unfortunately I get flanked. He and machine guns to taunt me. Yeah, one shots me, of course. I'm gonna play this helicopter this weekend in third person because oh, it's white. Because I had issues. I could not see my missiles at all. The missiles were just like invisible. So that missile, you saw like it just, where did it go? We just pause it. Okay. There is no missile. So that means the missile literally does not exist. Packalos ate it. Packalos ate that one as well. It's like gone. That one's also gone. It disappeared. And look how dangerously close I am. Now I finally see this one, but it lands short, unfortunately. The reason why it lands short is because I deliberately aimed short, thinking that the missile was not going to reach. And then I crash into invisible fence, of course. Because as you can see, if I go this, you can see the fence is right here. But if I go helicopter view, hang on, it's not letting me. Anyway, you can see there is no fence here. You can't see fences in aircraft. So that's unfortunate. And that was GG. I want to get best squad. Could not get best squad. One man, one army. And you can see they're all speaking Chinese because, you know, China's a meta now, especially in this lineup. WMA 301, bit OP. It's the premium that has everything: tandem missiles, proximity fuse HE, APF SDS. Even got HESH. Don't know why it needs HESH, but it's I don't know. I think it's the British L7 imported gun, imported manufactured. Let's see, yeah, it's got the same stats. But this is new, and this is new. Actually, no, this is not new. This is the same shell as the DM33, I think. 337 pen. Does it have? Yeah, it's the same shell. So it's got the same shell as a Leopard, but it's got 10 missiles and proximity fusee. Really good, premium. Yeah, I don't know why that's in the lineup. When, you know, stuff like the Japanese Type 8016, was it called? My computer's really eating it right now. Yeah, the Japanese Type 16, it's got the same gun, same shell, and it's, oh no, it's improved shell, okay. But it's not in the lineup, unfortunately. Even though it's somewhat worse. But the Centauro is. Centauro, what does it have? It's a 1-5 Centauro. It's got a DF-33 shell! Does it have a stabilizer? It's got ERA? And a two-plane stabilizer? What? What about the early one? I know the early one doesn't have ERA. It's got two-plane stabilizer. It's got DM-23. What the fuck? It's even got an M735. Why is that in the lineup? That's so unfair. And of course, China also gets the ZSU-57 proxy fuse shells. Where is it? WZ-35. What's the range? 15 meters. It's a okay fuse, 400 grams. I think Begleitpanzer has more. Begleitpanzer is a really good vehicle. Where is it? Yeah, it has more. It's got less high explosive, but more effective. But of course, America gets a Sergeant York, which is, I think it's superior to the 57. Been working pretty well for most people. 94. Okay, it doesn't have as good pen. So I guess it's not in superior because it has to fight armor. Russians don't really have to fight armor. I mean, like Leopard ones, just they're squishy. 45 people.